so weird.
Well, he's TV royalty at least. It's John Curshaw.
Grand to be back.
Look. Now, obviously, you're the king of doing Charles, but lots of people think that they can do him, including our baker boy here.
Mate, come on, you were doing it earlier
on. No, mine was awful. I mean, yours was better, in fairness. But what's the key? What's the key, John?
Well, I think Matt just demonstrated.
Go on.
You just need a little sound or a phrase or something that just, you know, gets you started on the wings of the ears. You know, it's very, very correct. I would say cufflink fiddle.
And then you're in there, then.
But he has heard it, hasn't he, the impression?
Oh,
is it right that he said that you could actually be his official stand-in?
Oh, yes, that's right. There was one time he put a party on for the... It was the anniversary of the Archers. Oh, and when we were doing Dead Ringers, we were invited to be the turn, you know, the comic turn on the night. And he was saying about how he's always been surprised at how impressionists have done him, all the way from Mike Yarwood to Bobby Davro and Rory Bremner. He's never fully aware of the affectations that one inevitably has.
Well, John's obviously not upset the royals too much, as he's hosting the 2-day Jubilee Family Festival in Hyde Park this weekend, and we'll chat more about that a little bit later on.
Of course, another big event this weekend is the Royal Pageant on the Thames this Sunday, and Cary Grant is there to see the first boats arriving. How are things looking over there, Cary?
Hi, Matt. Hi, Claire. Well, there's... Alex, sorry, they're starting together. But on Sunday, there's going to be an incredible 1,000 ships that have come to London to take part in the Queen's...
More from Cary later. Alex, it's over to you.
So, preparations are well underway for the pageant, but we want to see how your Jubilee preparations are going.
Yes, show us your bunting, is what we're asking tonight. Send us a photo to the One Show at bbc.co.uk.
Garages, sheds, streets, bunt us up.
Have you got any flags flying?
Bunt us up. I think it's wonderful, actually, and it's sort of building, isn't it? Buntings are spreading.
Yeah, that's happening in our village.
The whole nation's sort of turning into a sort of a classic 1950s postcard.
Yeah.
Flags everywhere, it's lovely.
It looks so pretty. Get the pictures in. Now then, fast fashion is in the news today. That's the term for the huge number of clothes being thrown out less than a year after being bought.
Yeah, we're sending 1 million tonnes of textiles to the dump every year. But if you do decide to have a clear out, well, there's a better place to chuck them than in the bin. Joe Crowley explains.
Bottoms.
You know, that kind of lot familiar. Ozzy Osbourne uniform, yeah.
So you actually, do you wear those ones?
Yeah, those are the ones that I use now, I portray Ozzy.
And when you go shopping, do you end up buying things that, you know, when you've got your subjects in mind?
Yes, I think so. Sometimes you might just spot something and you'll go, oh, there is a good Simon Cowell vest.
Yeah.
If you were going to do Matt, what would you buy?
Yours does quite fitted, isn't
well,
it?
Yeah.
With some of the shows, you know, those good square shoulders.
Now, this weekend, you're hosting the Jubilee Festival in Hyde Park on Saturday and Sunday. So what's on the bill, then?
Well, it's two packed days. It really is on the 2nd and the 3rd of June. And it's the kind of thing whereby if people are over in London to take in the Jubilee celebration, this is the kind of thing that you can bring the whole family to and just spend a couple of days there, really.
And visually, I mean, there's all sorts.
Yes.
I mean, Disney's quite a big
one. Yeah, that's right. There's the main stage in Hyde Park, and Mylene Klass and myself are hosting all the performances through that. And there's a 70-minute huge Disney show with all of those classic Disney tunes. And there's War Horse. They've got a performance going on.
Right.
I think two of the horses, they've got their own paddock by the side of the stage.
Oh, nice.
Well, they came here, didn't they? And they're absolutely huge, the horses. Yeah, there they are. We can see them.
Galloping around outside.
Yeah.
Weeks.
You forget very quickly that there are puppeteers operating them because it's so realistic how they just come to life.
And you've got a bit of Strictly?
Strictly, of course. Yes, you'll have to gate crash and join in. Yes, we need you, Alex, we need you.
There is a lot of attention, isn't there, on Britain at the moment, obviously with the Olympics and the Jubilee. You don't think we're going to crumble, do you?
Oh, certainly not. No, I don't think so. I think that there's a feeling of everything just building up and just when the moment's right. I think with the Olympics going on and the Jubilee and... I think Britain just won't. It's not ready for how brilliant it's going to be. Really, it's going to be superb, I think.
We're getting loads of bunting shots in, by the way.
Are we?
Just going to leave them up, aren't we, from now on?
I think so, yeah.
And we've been speculating who the last three people will be to carry the torch, you know, into the stadium. Any ideas?
Who could you have? I think maybe Professor Brian Cox would just hold.
the torch up and look at it as though it was our nearest star, the sun, or maybe Proxima Centauri. And then perhaps, I don't know, maybe Michael McIntyre can sort of skip along with the torch, or skipping along with the torch. This is what you're doing, this is what you're doing. Who else? John Bishop could hold the torch in that hand like that and sort of say it's his dream come true with the other hand like that, and that'd be just fantastic.
John, I think that's that today. That's very sad. I moved from Stoke-on-Trent over to Bolton.
Very good.
That was brilliant.
Yes, and you can see John hosting the Jubilee Family Festival at Hyde Park this weekend, and tickets are still available at the gate, which is good news.
Now, as we saw a little bit earlier on, boats are arriving in London from all over the world for the Queen's Diamond Jubilee pageant this Sunday.
Cary Grant's down at their East London Holden area to find out how on earth they're all going to make it down the river in one piece. Cary, please don't tell us there's been any accidents yet.
To the Queen! This has to be the best way to see the London skyline. I can see Canary Wharf, I can see the City of London. This is amazing!
And after 110 nautical miles, we round the Isle of Dogs and Tower Bridge comes into view. Simply breathtaking.
I, for one, have had the most amazing Channel crossing, and it's been great to be a part of the Bellamy's Virgin Voyage to London.
That was amazing. What an incredible experience. But today, they really brought out the VIPs. Prince Charles was on board, meeting the French ambassador. I bet he was a bit upset that he didn't get to climb the mast. Oh well. But all 1,000 ships are going to be sailing west on Saturday in preparation for Sunday's pageant. And that is where the fun begins. Tom Cunliffe, you're going to be there, aren't you? You are an expert in all things to do with boating. So is it difficult to get 1,000 ships sailing all together?
Difficult isn't in it. And the worst bit's at the start. Because you imagine, you've got 1,000 vessels. You probably think they all line up like Grand Prix cars, don't you, waiting for the green light?
Of course.
Well, they're in like that. A boat blows about on the water like a crisp packet. It goes all over the place.
So could they knock each other?
Yeah, they could. In fact, it's not unlikely that there will be some coming together, but we don't expect it's going to be too drastic because they'd put like with like.
Well, talking of grids, because you did mention that, we've got our own little grid of the order of service, as it were, of the boats coming on. What are you particularly looking forward to?
I think the rowing boats are going to be amazing. This is not a collection of bath boats in a country park, you know. This is the best selection of rowing craft you'll ever see. We've got Thames skiffs, little jewels of boats. We've got great big rowing boats like things you see on Canaletto Pictures. That's all there. Then we get the Dunkirk middle ships. What an opportunity to see all these vessels, without which, in 1940, despite Stukas and shellfire, there would have been no British army.
Now, as someone that doesn't know much about boats, what should I be looking for?
I think you should be looking out for the feeling of history that's here. I mean, the next lot through are going to be historic ships. Many of them are in the National Historic Fleet, the great vessels of the land.
So it's not just the big ships, it's also the little ones.
It is, absolutely. And all of them are involved with people. This is a people ceremony. Without people, there are no boats. Without boats, the people never happen. It's an effort together.
And you're going to be doing the commentary for the BBC on Sunday. We really wish you all the best with that. Later on in the show, I'm going to be interviewing some of the people that own the boats. So that's going to be fun. See you later.
Indeed. Thanks, Cary. Looking forward to hearing from Tom.
Yes.
Okay, John, now you're off on your travel soon, aren't you? With the tour,
oh, yes, because yes, the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, yes, yeah. The original radio cast coming back together to do a live version of the show.
Where did you jump on board that?
My section of it is in Leicester, okay. And also in Manchester, two nights in Manchester, where quite a number of us are going to be the guest voice of the book.
Brilliant.
And I was always a great fan of Hitchhiker's Guide, so yeah. I'm learning an impersonation of the original voice of the book, Peter Jones. I'm going to portray it as him as best I can.
Well, are you going to be a busy boy over the summer then? And you lot at home have been busy getting your bunting up. We've had loads of pictures.
You haven't let us down, thanks.
Now, this is the Rodney Pub in Little Baddow in Essex. What a great name for a pub, the Rodney. And that's from Tim Sargent.
Mark and Nick have sent this one in from Bournemouth. Our children love our house decorations. They've even put reinforcements up. Look at that. And John, you've got a quick one down there.
It's getting competitive between neighbours.
Rachel Coates in Worcester sent this one through of Holly the dog, who has flags growing out of her ears.
and we'll try to get more in a bit later. And now, when it comes to creating a new home, our wildlife man, Mike Dilger, can recommend the perfect builders.
Yes, they're hardworking. You only use the finest materials and can build a family home in about a week, and they're cheap. Cheap, cheap.
Britain is packed with complex feats of engineering designed by great architects.
Thoroughly enjoyable film. Imagine that being kissed by thousands of feathers.
Sleep like a baby.
Yeah. John, please tell us. Please tell us you have an impression of Mike Dilger.
He's fantastic, isn't he?
Yeah.
You know, David Attenborough does elephants and rhinoceroses, and I only get squirrels and chaffinches. There's no fur.
That's really good. It's very good. Anyway, time to head back to Kerry with the first boats to arrive for the Jubilee pageant this weekend. Now then, how are the crews feeling ahead of the big day? I don't know, let's ask them. How are you feeling? Yay! I think that's pretty good. It's time to meet the boat owners. Okay,
hello.
So what, Mike Sheffress, what type of boat?
I've got a motorboat.
A motorboat, and what will you be doing?
I'll be coordinating recreational motorboats.
Recreational, how many of them?
60 boats, and we've been rehearsing, get this right, got to get it right.
60 boats?
60 boats.
Rehearsing, I love that idea, choreography for boats.
Got to get it right.
Rather odd. Okay, Emily and Pamela,
yes.
Now what type of boat?
Dutch barge, Angelus.
And you found love on the river, didn't you?
I did. I bought a boat and my husband sort of lived next door on his.
And you ended up getting married. And then Emily came along and you grew up on the boat.
Yep, lived on a boat all my life.
Did you find love on the river?
I didn't find it on the river, but I have introduced love of the river to my husband as well.
And you had your wedding day there, didn't you?
We had the boat heavily involved. Our venue was chosen on the basis that we could have the boat involved, so it's great.
But now you've got land legs and you live in a house.
Never. It's a land vacation. We hope to go back to the river ourselves one day.
Thanks, guys. And finally, David Hunt, what's your type of boat?
She's an ex-Cornish fishing boat. She's a Dunkirk ship.
So you're one of the historic boats. How important is it for the historic boats this weekend to take part in the pageant?
We're all very proud. We've been asked the Dunkirk boats to come along.
How often do you meet up? Is this something that wouldn't happen very often?
We meet once a year, every year. And we all work very hard getting our elderly boats ready. We call it the Dunkirk spirit, getting them ready for the reunion. But this is the best one we've had, I think.
All the best with it. We're going to be looking out for you guys, especially for me. If you want to take part, you want to come down, then the places to avoid, they're saying avoid bridges. Lambeth, Westminster, Blackfriars have only got the ends of the bridges open. There's limited space there. So what we're looking for is for people to come down to the Thames onto the banks. There are 47 big screens there. You can see them on the map. They're marked in red and black. And that is where a million spectators apparently are going to be coming down to. Get there nice and early. Kicks off at 2 p.m. when the Queen goes onto her barge. And that's at 2 p.m. And you can find out more details via our link on the website. But I hear, Matt and Alex, you're going to be on the Thames too.
Yes, we're all part of it.
Yes, we'll be there on Sunday.
You're going to be cooking, aren't you?
Yeah, cooking up some Jubilee treats. Well, I won't be. Angela Harknett will be. You're not actually on the river, though,
no,
are you?
No, I'm in a studio with Sophie Redwell, but I wish I was on the boards anyway. Good, well, you certainly haven't disappointed us with all of the bunting pictures that you've been sending in. Have a look at this one. This has come from Kath in Cambridge, and this is Aidan Brooks Hospital car park. They keep raising the union flag. Look at that.
Nice. This is some bunting at Moore Primary School near Warrington. They're having a Jubilee party tomorrow for the children and retired residents. That's from Jan MacDonald, the head teacher.
Good. And John, you've picked out the best one.
Oh, yeah, this is astonishing. I want to announce this. As John Craven has a good country file item from Sarah Hammond and her picture of a patriotic cow. Matt Baker, we'll find out more.
Hey! Very good. Let's have a few more. We've got time for a few more. Look at the Queen there. Come on, love. Hurry up. Get on. Get on your way. This is from Twining Gloria. That's from Richard and Margaret.
And this lady is Hannah Bevington's mum, and she's bunted herself.
Yes! Very good.
Great.
If in doubt, bunt yourself. Thanks, John. The Jubilee Family Festival is on in Hyde Park this weekend with tickets available at the gate.
Yeah, and tomorrow Simon Pegg and Frankie Dettori will be here. We'll see you then. Bye.
Right, see you later.
Lucy has a lead on her